It's one of the oldest hormones. It's hundreds of millions of years old in the sense that it's conserved between fish and humans, pretty much. So this is something in the most primitive part of the brain, and among many of the other interactions it controls, one is bonding.
Welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Seth Lederman. He is the CEO of Tonix Pharmaceuticals. And Dr. Lederman, good to see you again. How are you?
I'm well. Thanks for having me on, Steve.
Yeah, so the company I was significant news talking about first patient being dosed in a focus study at Massachusetts General. And I want to talk to you a bit more about the platform that this will include in just a second, but maybe just update us on that particular study.
Yes, thanks, Steve. We're very excited. Arginine-vasopressin deficiency, AVP-D, is the new name for something that has been known for a long time as diabetes insipidus. And it relates to a problem in the brain that is an endocrine problem. And we're very excited to test our drug, TNX 1900, which is an intranasal oxytocin, in this rare condition. So it's being done by an expert team at Mass General Hospital. We're focused on vasopressin and oxytocin biology, and we're optimistic about the results of this study.
Talk to me a bit about oxytocin and how this is all related, because it's mentioned a lot in this particular release.
Yes, at Mass General Hospital, we have several other studies going on studying intranasal oxytocin. And we are excited about the platform. Oxytocin is a natural human hormone. And in the intranasal form, there's not an available prescription drug in the United States, but oxytocin intravenously, and sometimes IM, is used to induce labor. So it's well known as a natural human hormone and something that's used at higher doses systemically in certain medical settings to induce labor. But we're looking at it in a completely new way, which is basically to look at the effects it will have from intranasal, where it can affect things like the trigeminal ganglia and other structures close to the brain, adjacent to the brain, and maybe even penetrate into the brain through the nasal cavities.
So does this, it's known as, I was reading in the news release, the bonding hormone. So is that the key to this, that it's able to attach on to certain things, and that's what allows it to be potentially used in these type of ways?
Yes, it does have that name in the popular literature, but it's one of the oldest hormones. It's hundreds of millions of years old in the sense that it's conserved between fish and humans, pretty much. So this is something in the most primitive part of the brain, and among many of the other interactions it controls, one is bonding. It's most famous for maternal fetal bonding, but you also probably know it because when a dog looks at you and the dog's eyes dilate, that's believed to be oxytocin. So it's involved in a lot of social interactions, and that's one of the reasons we're optimistic about its effect in diabetes insipidus, because there are social and mental issues that are associated with diabetes insipidus, and we're optimistic that this could be a potential solution for these patients.
And taking us back to the beginning here of this study at Mass General, this is really important because it gives you a lot of data that you can use in the future for potential, as you mentioned, other uses for oxytocin.
Yes, and it's very important that we're able to go into a number of different studies using the same drug device combination. It's an applicator that puts the oxytocin to the nose. And in addition to these studies at Mass General, we've also announced that we're planning a study in Prader-Willi syndrome, which is an orphan condition, and also a condition in which there's some evidence that oxytocin could be beneficial.
All right. Well, we'll see what happens. Dr. Lederman, thanks so much. Really good update from you again today, and I appreciate your time.
Thank you very much, Steve.
All right, Dr. Seth Lederman, the CEO of Tonix Pharmaceuticals.